Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Outlook video for you today. I'm going to cover 10 Outlook tips that you should know. It has to do with just laying out your Outlook and just organization. Let's go ahead and dive in right now. Tip number one has to do with the reading pane. My Outlook, I am on the desktop, I am on a PC. The only thing different that I have running is these icons over on the far left, inbox, calendar, people. You probably have those in the bottom left. They will soon be up here in the top left. No big deal. Everything else is the same. So let's go to the reading pane. By default, you're on your inbox and I'm on the word home. You want to go to the view tab. The reading pane is in the layout group. Select reading pane. My reading pane is currently off. It's on the right, select an email, and there is your reading pane. If you don't like the reading pane, you can put it at the bottom and you can also turn it off. During the day, I go back and forth with the reading pane, turning it on and off depending on what I'm doing, and I'll explain that more in a second. You can also resize your reading pane. Now my reading pane is really wide, so my messages got collapsed a little bit. Not a problem. You can always pull that back out. And if you're wondering, I've got columns here from subject, received, categories, mentions. When you pull the reading pane over to the right and this gets collapsed, you can always right click a message and get to your options. So if I wanted to categorize an email, I could come to categorize right here. Tip number two is the to-do bar. I'm going to go quickly turn the reading pane off just for a second. Why would you want to use the to-do bar, which is also in the layout group? Instead of jumping back and forth from your inbox to your calendar, because if you're like me, I'm in my inbox and my calendar all the time, you can go to the to-do bar and click on the calendar. It will appear over on the right-hand side of your screen. And once again, just like the reading pane, you can resize it right here. I'm going to close it. You can also go to the to-do bar and hit off. It's the same as clicking the X. You can have the to-do bar calendar and the reading pane running at the same time if you want. Third easy tip for you. I'm going to just stay here in this layout group that we're in. We've looked at the to-do bar. We've looked at the reading pane. Your folder pane is what you see over on the far left-hand side of your screen. This right here is the folder pane. Folder pane is normal for me. I just turned it off. I can go back and make it minimized. I can go back and make it normal. And I can even come in here and notice that favorites is checked. Favorites are showing up right before, right up in the top left. I'm going to click on favorites and I don't see my favorites anymore. Totally up to you how you organize this. One other little tip. If you're on the home tab, I'm on the home tab again, and I don't want to have to go to view folder pane. This arrow right here will minimize the folder pane. And then when you click it, it comes back. But here's the tip. If I move over here, it's going to minimize again immediately. So you can also come in here and select pin the folder pane. Now it always stays. So that's a question I get sometimes. Tip number four, I need certain emails. I need to be reminded about them and quickly find them. This is a great tip. I've already flagged one of these emails intentionally. You can either come over here and use the flag, but just to show you this, I'm going to go and turn on the reading pane again to the right. And then I'm going to do the same thing I did before. So now I don't see the flags. So here's an email from Carol Wilson about the new travel policy. Right click, follow up flag. There are your follow up flag options. I'm going to set this one for no date. But if you wanted to be reminded about this tomorrow, you would click tomorrow. This week, next week, but I'm going to do no date. There's a flag. I can also just click this flag here, but I usually like to right click I'm going to do one more, no date, but here comes my cool tip for you. So you've just flagged a couple messages for no date. We've already looked at the to-do list, the calendar, and these are important emails that I maybe need to act on or do something with. So I'm going to go to view again. I'm already there. Let's say I don't want the reading pane on, so I'm going to turn it off, but I could have left it on. To-do bar, task. Look, my no dates are up here immediately, and I can quickly get to them and say, okay, these are the emails that are really important. That's my tip for you right there. I'm going to close this. You can also sort by your flags in case you ever need to, ascending sort and descending sort. Just tell me by flag. To get back to your default sort, usually we have the most current email at the top and then working down. You want to sort by received, which leads me to tip number five, how to add and remove columns and move them around. I have even done this accidentally. I have the column heading from, followed by subject, followed by received. I'm going to right click on the received column and remove this column. So now I would be really aggravated because I got from subject but no received. Just simply right click any one of these columns and you want to use the field chooser. In the field chooser, it is set to frequently used fields. I just know this from experience. You're going to find received here. But in case you're wondering, are there other fields that I'm missing? Sure, you can go to all document fields if you need to. You can go to all mail fields, but I'm going to just stay with frequently used. Go down. Here's received, so I want to add it back. Click, drag, and drop. Usually you get two red arrows there showing where it's going to drop it. I don't know why the red arrows aren't showing. I'm going to stay there. Here's my point. If you put it in the wrong place, let's say I put it right here. So I got it in front of subject, just drag it to the right of subject. So just click, drag, and drop. There's usually some red arrows here, and maybe I'm in this slightly new version. No big deal. It does work though. That's the important point. Next tip. I need to do this one all the time. A lot of people will send me an email. But the email is actually to schedule a meeting. They want to meet, but I got it as an email. So let's turn on the reading pane. Reading pane is on to the right over here. Can we have a meeting? I'm making this up. Can we have a meeting? Sure. So when I'm on this meeting message right here, and I'm on the home tab up in the top left, go click on home. There is reply, reply all forward. But if you notice in here, there's an icon right there that says reply with meeting. When I click that, Carol Wilson sent this to me and Christian. So when I click on reply with meeting, it turns it into a meeting. It kept the subject as the title. The required are now Carol and Christian because I said reply with meeting. And I just come in here and pick a date and time. If they are your coworkers, I would recommend using the scheduling assistant. But there you go. And also, the body of the email is now in the body of the meeting invite. Really cool feature. Close that out. Tip number seven. I want to categorize an email. I believe I may have already showed this, but here you go. I'm going to right click on an email, categorize. You can change the name of these colors. So instead of saying blue category, I could make this say marketing. I could make green be HR. I could name them after apps, Excel, Word. I'm going to just use a blue here. Here's where I can change it. I'm going to call this marketing. Right click another one, marketing. Right click one more, marketing. What I love about categories, I do use folders, but the thing is, I only will drag an email to one folder. But if I'm on my inbox, I can have multiple categories for one email. In real life, I would be renaming these probably, but I believe you see where I'm headed. One more. There you go. Guess what? You can sort by your categories. There you go. I'm going to go back and sort by received. So now you know how to right click into a category. If your reading pane is off, you'll see it up here. So it all depends on that reading pane, how wide it is. Tip number 8 is really simple. This one's a big one for me. You may or may not like it, so let me just find out. If I go to the View tab, go to the View tab with me, it says Show Focused Inbox. I have already turned this on, so I'm going to turn it off. Before I turn it off, look, I have Focused and I have Other. So now I am using the default for Outlook, which is All and Unread. I don't care that I have all and unread. This is just me personally. I rather see the focused inbox. What happens is with artificial intelligence, Outlook decides, okay, this message is important, so I'm gonna put it in your focused. These messages aren't that important. If you notice, look, Costco, I like Costco, Dow Jones, Barron's. So they put these here. You can make a message that's an other. You can easily move it to focused, and also you can take a focus message and move it to other. You can do one, or you can do always. That is right in here. I'm going to go back to the focus tab, and I've still got this running. If you want to turn it off, turn it off. Tip number 9. I've read a few of these emails. I got 3 unread emails at the top, and then at least a couple unread. This message that says budget meeting, I've read it, but now I want to leave it back as unread. Budget meeting, right click, and there is mark as unread. It is now the 4th message down in blue font. So that is how you take a message that you've read and make it unread. Last tip, tip number 10 is a big one. I know a lot of people love the reading pane. Well, here's one of the issues with the reading pane. View, reading pane, I don't care where you put it, if it's on the right or the bottom. If it's off, you don't have this issue. But if I go to options, okay, I've now put it back on the default right here. So when I hit OK, here's the issue people have. I'm going to click on the first email. I'm going to use the arrow key to move down to the second, the third, the fourth. I'm hitting the arrow key on my keyboard. Take a look at all the emails from the first one down to the 7th or 8th one. Just clicking them, if the reading pane is turned on, marks them as read. Well, maybe I just wanted to get a quick glance at them, but I don't want them marked as read. So, we'll see if this trick works. Mark as unread, okay. By the way, I selected a bunch of read and made them unread. Here we go, so they're in blue. Reading pane options. You want to turn off mark items as read when the selection changes. That is what needs to be turned off. Click OK. Here we go again. I click on that first email just to get a quick glance of what it's about. Don't care about it now. Down arrow. Don't care about it. Down arrow. My message are still unread. That is that tip right there. Those are the 10 tips I have for you. If you have any other additional tips about just layout, feel free to let me know. Put them in the comments down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, if you want to subscribe and ring the bell, I'd appreciate that. Hope you have a great weekend and a great day. Thank you.